Welcome back to the channel. In this video, I want to give you some insights and hints about the Burp Suite Certified Practitioner exam without no spoiler. As you can see, I got the certification on 23 October 2022. The certification is valid for 5 years. Therefore, it's useful to build a strong career into the cybersecurity sector or to start a decent path into bug bounty, because as you can see, this certification provides you with a lot of skill that could fit with cybersecurity sector or bug bounty path. Let's read the ability that you will be able to demonstrate while you are performing this certification. Detect and prove the full business impact of a wide range of common web vulnerabilities, such as OWASP Top 10 2021, adapt attack methods to bypass broken defenses using knowledge of fundamental web technologies, because most of the time you need to exploit things with some small scripts or made in JavaScript, like fetch function and other kind of, and also try to debug the workflow request with the developer tool of Google Chrome, because most of the time you can try some attacks, but you will face content security policy, which can lead you to rabbit hole. And if you are using the Google developer tool, you will be aware of it, and you can move to another kind of attack, another kind of vulnerability, without being stuck for a lot of minutes into this kind of rabbit hole. And another thing is quickly identify weak points within an attack surface and perform out-of-band attacks to attack them. Most of the time you need to extract data from the application toward the external server, a collaborator server. Out-of-band attacks indicates that you need to have a collaborator server which is available just on the professional version and on in the community version of Burp Suite. And you need also to be quick to identify weak points and to perform this kind of attack. I suggest you an article made by Micah, which is very useful because it has a lot of hints without no spoiler and tips. But the most important thing that I found was this table of contents regarding the categories of the vulnerabilities that you can face during the exam, or you can use it also for the preparation of the exam and try to make a good scheme, good notes about it. I was stuck in the exam on stage 2 in one application, and this table helps me a lot because I found very useful this kind of structure to understand what kind of attack you have already done and what kind of attack you didn't take. So take a copy of this table, save it, edit in a way that could be comfortable with you, and use it also for the preparation part provided by portswigger, because this preparation path is made by 4 steps. The first step is to complete 1 lab for every topic, but I suggest you to complete all the labs from every topic of practitioner, apprentice level. There is also expert level, but during the exam is required just apprentice and practitioner. Therefore, while you're performing these labs, take notes methodically and structure it very well in order to be readable during time and useful for this exam and for future purpose. In the step 2, you need to solve these 7 labs that you have already faced in step 1, but portswigger selected them because you need to understand the codings, using them to evade defenses and proficiency in exploiting cross-user attacks. These labs could be very useful to test your notes and to test your knowledge at this kind of step to understand if you are ready to perform this kind of attack quickly and try to build some payloads, because they are not simple attack, they are more process step attack. And this is very useful to understand what kind of methodology is required for the exam, what kind of logic mental shape you need to have. Once you're done with this, proceed to the step 3. Integrate the step 3 with the table of MICA, because the step 3 is the mystery lab, which this function is useful to train your econ, because you can select apprentice or practitioner. And into the category, you can go randomly on the world category of the vulnerabilities of the labs, or you can pick just one or more than one and focus on that and try to understand if you are able to recognize as quick as possible vulnerabilities and your nodes, if they are you good for that kind of attacks, or you need to improve it, you need to change it. And save also this list, the username and password, because they are useful for the brute force attacks. And after you are comfortable with the step 3, pass to the step 4. The step 4 is the practice exam. The practice exam is very similar to the full exam, but is always the same. Instead, the full exam has an algorithm that you will always face another different exam, but the structure is always on 3 stages. And maybe before you take this exam, take a look on INTS and guidance, which this article is very useful because it makes you understand what kind of requirements you need to have before taking the practice exam and exam as well. And read it carefully, and read also this part, which is very interesting, and it can give you a lot of open shape mind. And before you take the practice exam, also this article is made for registration process and exam as well, but take a look at this, what the exam involves, because these stages are structured, the main structure is always the same, and change the vulnerabilities, but if you are comfortable with this stage progress, you will be able to move during the exam smoothly without falling into the rabbit hole. Therefore, read carefully all the articles that I will insert in the description of the YouTube video. And after that, try the practice exam and start to train yourself in order to finish it as quick as possible into the time frame provided. If you face some problem, there is also these 2 resources very useful. That one is this video solution made by Andy Lee, which is not about the solution, it's more about the logic that it takes to solve the labs. And you can take notes and understand what kind of tool is using at the moment. And also there is this literal solution, this article. It's very similar to the video, but it's more readable, and you can pick some hints from here, or pick some tool that you're using in extension. Practice a lot in this practice exam. If you solve it at the first try, take it 2-3 times more, just to be comfortable with the timing, comfortable with encoding, and revise this full article and the other that I insert below in the description, because if you study this article and try to understand them as well, you will be able to do a decent exam and pass it on the first try. Therefore, take good notes, think carefully while you are performing the exam, don't panic, and use this table, it's very useful. And wish you best luck.